So in this slide and the next, what we're going to do is draw the pathway for fine touch and proprioception. And then as we're going, we'll kind of compare and contrast with gross touch. And then we'll talk a little bit about some of these differences and why they're important. So to begin, so fine touch, let me see. Here's a penny, and here's a dime. Dimes are rough, pennies are smooth. You can feel the difference between a penny and a dime because of your fine touch sense. Proprioception, again, is knowing where your limbs are in space, and that travels with fine touch. So there's a dorsal root, so you have a finger, and a thumb, and a, well, you know me and my drawing. So anyway, so here's the dorsal root ganglion neuron, which is number one in the chain. And it enters the dorsal horn. It may kind of give a sidebar chat with some of the neurons here, but for the most part, it doesn't really, it's not its biggest synapse, and it travels in this dorsal horn, in the dorsal columns. If it's from the leg, it is in the gracilis. If it's from the arm, it's in the cuneatus. It comes up to the medulla oblongata and synapses appropriately either in the gracilis nucleus or the cuneatus nucleus, okay, based on whether it was traveling in which of these parts of the dorsal columns. These neurons cross the midline, and now they're called, this fiber tract is called the medial lemniscus. These fibers of these secondary neurons that have crossed the midline ascend to the thalamus, where they synapse again on a thalamic neuron, which goes to the primary somatosensory cortex. So what I hope you do is get a piece of paper. You don't have to draw in pretty spinal cords. You can just draw boxes or circles or whatever you want to draw, and practice drawing fine touch and proprioception, and practice drawing gross touch, so you remember where the second neuron in the chain crosses. Because remember, this first neuron is very simple. It's always going to be the DRG neuron. The third neuron is also simple. It's always going to be the thalamus neuron. It's this second neuron that can cause some consternation and some confusion. But once you get that down, you've got the sensory system down. So in the next slide, we're going to go over it in boxes, because boxes are even easier than brains. So again, another way of, you know, another schema to look at fine touch and proprioception is to remember that there's a stimulus. The first neuron is in the dorsal root ganglion. That dorsal root ganglion neuron then goes into the spinal cord and goes through either the fasciculus cuneatus or the fasciculus gracilis. It then synapses in the medulla in the nucleus cuneatus or the nucleus gracilis. These are the second order neurons. They cross the midline, and we call them arcuate fibers when they cross the midline. And then they ascend or go to up towards the brain via the medial lemniscus. They synapse in the thalamus, and then that third neuron projects to the somatosensory cortex, where it comes to perception. So again, the first neuron and the third neuron are where they always are, in the DRG and in the thalamus. The second neuron for gross touch is going to be in the spinal cord, and its axons cross. For fine touch and proprioception, the second neuron is in the medulla, and those are the neurons that cross. So it's always the second neuron that crosses the midline. So to summarize, again, how many neurons does it take to relay fine touch and proprioception to the primary sensory cortex? Where are these neurons located? Which of the axons cross the midline? Where does that axon cross the midline? And then where does this axon travel as it ascends towards the brain. So where does it travel in the spinal cord? Where does it travel in the brainstem? Once you understand these things, you'll be ready for the assessment. Practice drawing. Doesn't matter how pretty or how ugly your own illustrations are, but once you draw it, you'll understand it and you'll be ready for the assessment.